So I'm back with a new video and let's talk about Malignant. So this is going to be interesting because Malignant is one of those movies that it's creating a lot of debate online recently. I had no idea, like, as you know, I've been busy with festival season, and only now, like yesterday, at the time that I'm filming this, I had the opportunity to go and watch Malignant at the cinema, and I had heard mostly good things, but apparently people either love or hate this film, and yeah, let's just get into it so I can tell you where I land. So, if you don't know what Malignant is about, I would say you're in the best position to go watch it, because I didn't really know what it was about when I went in, and I had seen the trailer, but the trailer doesn't give much away. In my opinion, I only watched it once, so I can't really tell you much about it. But yeah, I've watched the trailer, I knew it was a James Wan film, and obviously the poster has been around like everywhere, so I knew that. But just a sort of little plot that I can tell without getting into much detail is that the movie follows Madison, who starts seeing visions of gruesome murders, and then she realizes those murders are happening in real life, like they're really happening. And yeah, that's all I can tell you without giving too much away, because this is one of those films that has a lot of themes and you might be spoiled, and I don't want that, because you have to figure this out for yourself. So the film actually stars a pretty good cast of a lot of people that I know. Obviously I know the main actress Annabelle Wallis, I know her from Peaky Blinders, but she's also in the first and the second, but the first Annabelle film. And it's funny because she lived here in Portugal for most of her childhood, from what I know. And she comes back often, so that is nice. But the movie also stars Mehdi Hassan, who I know from We Summon the Darkness. Stars also George Young, who I know from Containment. And Michelle Brianna White, I hope I'm pronouncing her name right, and that's the only cast member, like main cast member, that I don't really know. So yeah, it's a interesting group of actors. And with all that said, let's get into my thoughts. So where do I land? I guess I land in the middle. Believe it or not, I'm not in either end. I didn't love it, but I didn't hate it either. I left the cinema like really conflicted. Like, on one hand, I really enjoyed the originality of the film and how crazy it is, because it is insane. It is like, what the hell is happening? It has so much going on, and yeah, it's bonkers. Like, it's what everyone says it is. Yeah, it's crazy, it's wild, it's insane, it's all of that, and I really enjoyed the aspect. But it's also really cheesy and cringy and over the top, and I was really confused with that, because I went in expecting a more serious movie. And I think this is one thing that you need to know before going into it. After reading on the movie and on what everyone was saying, I realized it is supposed to be cheesy, because James Wan based it around like 80s films, like those really cheesy over the top 80s films, and I can appreciate that. And after knowing it, I realized like it was intentional, because I was really confused. It was way too cheesy. And now that I know that it was intentional, I can appreciate it a bit more. But I also wish I knew that before going into it, because without knowing that, I just didn't like it as much as I thought I would. Like, I'm pretty sure I would feel almost the same way, but I was just expecting a more serious film, and it's not serious, it's not meant to take seriously. So you need to know that before going into it. It's supposed to be crazy and over the top and cheesy. But unfortunately, I'm not really into those 80s movies. So although I did enjoy the originality and all of that, I was a bit let down by how cheesy it is, how over the top it is. But I have to talk about the cinematography, which is amazing. It's probably the best thing about the film. James Wan did an amazing job with all the effects and the practical effects, and yeah, everything on a technical level was really good. The score was a bit, again, just over the top, as well as the acting, which, again, now I know it was intentional, but it was still a bit too much for me. I did like the opening titles. They were like really 2000s vibes, and they really reminded me of Saw, so James Wan. The vibe of the film also is a bit similar to Insidious, even though I feel like Insidious is more serious and this one is not. So there's that. And obviously, like, the twists and turns and all of that, I didn't see it coming. It kept me guessing throughout the whole film, which I love. So overall, I give the film a 3.5 out of 5. Above average, because I did like the aspect that it's really different, and different than what I was expecting. So even though it was a bit too much at times for me, I can appreciate it. Cinematography wise, I give it a 4 out of 5. As I said, it's great. Yeah. And originality, I also give it a 4 out of 5. It is like a mix of different films, but I can't remember a movie that has the same plot, the same like issue. I can't really remember. So yeah, and besides, it's just crazy, and there's not a film like this one, I don't think. So yeah, so these are my thoughts on Malignant. Believe it or not, I didn't love it, I didn't hate it, I liked it. I do want to rewatch it, and maybe I like it more now that I know that it's supposed to be over the top. But yeah, in the meantime, these are my thoughts. Let me know in the comments what you thought. Are you one of those that loved it? Are you in the minority, I guess, that didn't really like it? Let me know. And yeah, if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, and I'll see you in my next video.